Hi, welcome back all of you to the third session of the day. This is going to be a very tough one, and then please keenly watch and then shoot questions so that what happens you'll understand it. Fine, it's a very tough one. Fine, watch it. So let me first of all, what happens, save the file actually, whatever has gone. What is this place? The costing setups too actually. Expand it. Expand it. Classroom records, man. All right. I'll save it. So it's the 18th, and then this is the 19th one. Right click and then rename 19th. And tomorrow we are going to see intra costing now, IoT costing. That will be even so tough actually. Costing setup store. So at the end of the day, what happened? The 18, 19, 20 will be uploaded in a file. Now, what I do is I go there. Fine, I will now hide the floating meeting controls. So I will now go to the stuff. So next is what? Default cost profile. So the default cost profile is basically what it is for every cost or cost book combination, and then everybody has to do. Only valuation structure we cannot repeat, whereas the cost profiles as well as the default cost profiles, everybody has to do. Fine, click on the manage default, default cost profiles, we go there, and then let me create a person. They are all cost or cost book specific now. The cost org is what T01 and then give it app. Cost book is what T01 and then give it app. You can even category wise also you can cost it. There is again a very tough one actually. Nobody has done it. None of my students are doing it category wise costing. We can even do category also.
Nana, can you click on the list of values?
Here, call category code.
Yeah.
All the categories will be coming. So whatever categories you have defined in the inventory, now everything will be coming.
Okay.
But category-wise, don't go at all. It will be very, very complex actually. None of my students have done it actually. And then whenever you're creating a new item, what happens? You automatically associate the auto. Click on auto. So go there. Auto means what? It will automatically assign the cost profile to you. So go there, right-click and then duplicate. I will now show you how the profiles get associated to the line now. Thank you for it. I will go to the product management, and then I go to the product information management. And then when I am going to create an item, we will now see now. I click on it. So click on create item. I am now creating a new item. So the profile gets associated automatically on this. I click on OK. It's OK. So here, what I'm going to do is what? Go there in this place. When you're creating an item, actually. Let us now create an asset item actually. So we are now going to create an asset item. So once when you create an asset item, the asset profile gets associated automatically. Okay, again, what happens? I know run a wrong one now. Fine, I should have used the automative actually. It's okay, it's not coming. I'm not going to save it actually. Go to the specifications. You go to the specifications. Fine, go to the specifications. And then if you're creating an item, like what happens, you go there. This one, costing enabled, and then inventory asset values, yes. This is called an asset item. Costing enabled and then inventory asset value is this. Then if you do it, what happens? This profile gets associated now. Fine, the auto. If you go there, the cost asset cost profile is what T01 and then give it app. This gets enabled for this item. So if an item is going to be an asset item, this profile gets associated to the item actually. And if you're creating an item, fine, go there. If you're creating an item, like what happens? If you go there, if you say what? The inventory asset value is going to know this becomes an expense item. Fine. If an item is having costing is enabled and then inventory asset value is no, it is an expense item. Then what happens? This profile gets associated. You go to the expense profile, fine, T01, and then give it app. So this expense profile will be associated with the item actual. And then similarly for the consigned, I don't know consigned actually. Consigned, I don't know. Fine. So we have got three different profiles which can be created. And then depending upon the items, activity, items, item attribute, what happens, the respective profile gets associated to the item actually. Any doubts? So I've only done two because the third one, I don't know. So go there. So don't give any category codes. Fine. Go there. It's auto. No. Fine. It's auto means auto. And then the if asset item, this profile will now get associated. For the expense, this will be getting associated. Clear? Any doubts? Good. No doubts. Fine. So click on save and close. Consigned, I don't know. It's a very tough one, and then keenly watch now, because people make a lot of mistakes on this now and over there. So, okay, fine. Now, the the default cost profile for asset and expense has been created actually. And then these default cost profiles are cost or cost book specific. Now, fine, click on edit. Now, fine, click on. They are all cost or cost book specific. Now. Go there. I will click on edit now. Click on edit. So once you edit it, whatever. They are cost or cost book specific actually. One cost or can have multiple cost books and also there is a big hierarchy and all, right? Those things and all, I don't know how they are all working actually. So you can even have a hierarchy of this now. Thank you, cancel. It's only a simple one I have made now. So it is for every cost or cost book combination, we have to have a default cost profile. Thank you, that's what else. And then your cost org will be saying which are all the inventory org which has associated it. Thank you, that. So that way it comes. So the final setup is now going to come up. Thank you, madam. The final setup is now coming up. That is what's called manage valuation units. Manage valuation units. So go there. So good, manage VALU percentage, UNIT percentage. Go there. So manage valuation units. So click on it. So go there. Click on plus now. So this also everybody has to create. One, go there. The cost org is what? T01. And then give it tab. The cost book is T01. And then give it tab. The valuation unit, I'm going to give it a friend. T01. It is an asset valuation unit now. So I'm now creating an asset valuation. Remember, everybody has to create it. Only on the valuation structure, you cannot create if somebody has created. Whereas cost profiles, default cost profiles, and then valuation unit, everybody has to create. Okay, this is enough and take off it, and then put on the description. Go there. So valuation structure code, it is going to be T01 or D01. Anybody? It is going to be T01 or D01.
D01.
Please mute your mic now. It is a D01. Remember, my valuation structure is not yours. I'm going to use this one now. This is the asset one. Asset valuation structure. And then we are going to add the values for it now. We are going to add the values. So it is a valuation unit for this combination. Again, cost or cost book combination. Fine. For the valuation structure, we are to add now. Fine. Click on plus now. I'm going to add it. So go there. So here, it is a cost or inventory or. Fine. Go there. Click on it. Now tell me, what is my cost or number, cost or code? Anybody remembering? Cost or code I have given now. Anybody remembering it? Yeah. Come on.
T001
is very correct. The Thirney girl is very correct. T00, fine, if you write it off, it will be coming. And then what is the inventory or code?
T011.
Fine, this is one set now. Fine, click on again. So we have one more set also. Fine, we have almost it also. Fine, click on plus now. We'll now add the second set actually. So it's now giving you a warning now. Fine, it's already existing. Do you want to get SSS? Because I got two calls. Fine, now saying click on S now. Fine, click on it. The warning EVS. Go there. So here, go there. Click on it. So we have one more R now. Fine, go there. So T01. T001. It is a T012. T012 the one. Fine, click on it. So similarly, we have to create one for expense valuation also. And then one for consigned valuation also. Got it now, fine? So we are not going to test those things now, fine? We are going to test only asset. Thank you. So expense, what happens? The expense structure will be coming. For which, what happens? We have to add the valuation units now. The valuation unit is a two-segmental one. Cost org and then inventory org. I did for a three-segmental one. Cost org, inventory org, and sub-inventory also. So they will all be very complex actually. Any doubts? Good then, fine, fine. So we have completed all the costing setups. So complete costing setups on the complete item. Right? Concept goes. Now we are going to create an item. So once when you create an item, I'm going to create an asset item. So the asset cost profile gets associated automatically because that is coming under my T01 cost org. My org is not coming. So the asset cost profile will be getting automatically associated to the particular item actually. So click on 7 plus. Similarly, if I create an expense order, that will be coming. Fine with that. So after having done all the setups, it is preferable to what? Log out and log in now. Fine, click on it. You know, log out and log in. Sign out and sign in. Sign out and sign in. Fine, go that one. And then we don't sign in now. So click on sign in. So we are not signing in. So it's not done. Now what happens? I will now go there and then create my item. Fine. I will now click on the star icon. We will now see whether the item is added. Fine. Go to the favorites now. Fine. Click on it. I will now see it's not added. No, fine. I will now first of all go to the product management and then go to the product information management and then let me add to the favorites now. So click on the favorites and then add to the favorites now. Fine. Click on add to favorites. They're coming. I go there. So click on save and close. And then you will not go there and then create an item. So click on it. I'm not going to create an item. It's an asset item I'm going to create now. The expense item is a lab exercise for you. I go there. If the root item class is now giving a problem, so what happens? I go there. I will now choose what automotive. Right? Automotive I'm going to choose. So click on it. What is the significance of the item class will be explained during what happens your product data hub. No, fine. The full explanation will be given during product data hub. So I'm now choosing the automotive because this is not having any problem. No, fine. Click on OK now. Because root item class, somebody has modified it. I click on it. No, fine. Now, what happens? You'll now find that what happens? The item number are coming up. So these two are OK. Now, fine. They are having values. And then here, all the four are having a value. It's OK now. I will not go there. I will not put my first item. Fine. T0101. Fine. I will not say cost test. Cost test. Fine. I'm not going to get only one asset. Expense is a lab access, and then consigned is also a lab access. So if you go to the specifications, fine, go to the specifications, and then here in the manufacturing, if what happens, your costing enabled is this, and then inventory asset value is this, what happens, it is the asset item. So the asset cost profile gets associated to the item automatically. Okay. So go there. Go to the associations, and then let me associate to the first order. Okay. I will not go there tomorrow. I will not associate the first one. Go to the actions and then go to what? Select NAT. So the profiling is auto. So T011 entry now. That will be getting associated to the item automatically. Fine, click on apply and then click on done. You know that? Fine. You do not have a permission to assign the item. Fine, go there. So that means what? We need a product data steward license now. Fine, go there. So a product data steward is required. Fine, go there. So it is not coming. Fine, go there. So click on save now. I will not save it. T0101 costs this now. You are not having a permission. It is not saying. So we'll now go and then provide the role of product
data access. Sir.
Data access is not required. For item creation, what happened? The role is required.
For because association, sir. For association of org, we need a data access, I think.
No, not data access, actually. It is not a data access. It is actually what happens, had I assigned to 001, it will get assigned. But my org, fine, it is a T01, fine, for which what happens, we need a role. Because that role is already inbuilt on the, what happens, your org now. Fine. You go to the place, fine, click on it. I will not go there, click on it. I will not go to the what tools.
No, I think you need to add this T011 and T012 into that.
Not. One minute, I will not come now. Fine, click on. I will not go there. Come on. I will not go there. So go to the users now, fine, go to the users, fine, go there. The SCM10. SCM10, fine. I will not go there, click on it. I will not click on edit now, fine. I will not click on edit. I will not go to the add. Product data steward, I'm going to add now.
Sir, product data steward role, I have given this.
You already given, huh?
Yeah, product data steward, and I think the product manager as well.
Product data steward is sufficient. No, fine, go ahead. Not. It is not visible at all. And I will not add and see nothing. I'll go there. It's a product data fine steward. See, if it is not giving, it will not come in the list of value at all. It is there. That means what? It is not given. So product data steward is not done. So click on add role membership. So click on done. So click on save and close. I have now added the product data steward. Now fine, click on it. So click on done. I will now log on and on. Before which, what happens, since you made a change, no fine, you go there and then what happens, you go there. And then run this now, fine, go there. Schedule process. You click on the run the schedule process. So click on the schedule new process. I will now say, what happens, import. User role. So import user role, I'm doing in a fine click on product data steward is added. Because it is for my T011 org. So we have to wait for some time now. Fine. No worry. So once when this is completed, what happens? We will now log out and log in. Fine. Import. Import user role will now, what happens, is sync all the security console setups into the transaction systems actually. You know what I mean? So we added and then now force syncing it actually. Internally, what happens, it will be doing it automatically or rather it will now have its own time of syncing actually, but we are now force syncing with this. So let us now go there. I will now log out and now find out. So sign out and then sign in. So before which, what happens, I will know, what happens, it will take some time. So I will now tell you tomorrow's theory actually. Tomorrow's theory I'm going to set. So let me go there and then tell you about the tomorrow's theory actually. Because it has to take some time actually. So here what I do is I'll now go there. I'll now say fusion inventory product data hub. In the inventory documentation, fine, go there. Rather not this one. I will not go to the what the fifth one. Additional docs records 5 when go that click on a double click on. And then I will now open up what the 03 one. On the additional docs records 5, we have the 03 documentation. Asset expense items and subinventories. So double click. So now, whenever you are making a transaction in the whatever in the shop floor, no, fine. So there are two types of items. One is an asset item, one is an expense item. And then there are two types of subinventories. One is the asset subinventory, and then one is an expense subinventory. So this is now going to explain you this. Let us say we are now using what happens. Yeah, this thing now. Fine. We are now what happens? We are now running the a mill now, rolling mill actually. So we buy the what happens the big steel rods actually, and then roll it into what happens. We'll now be what happens the billets. We'll now be buying the steel billets and then roll it into steel rods actually. That is our business actually. So we will now buy kerosene. Kerosene is an asset item. And then whenever you're pumping into the furnace, this transaction is known as asset into asset subinventory actually. This comes under first one. Asset item into asset subinventory. And then you will now issue kerosene to a maintenance subinventory, which is very near to the furnace. And then we'll now issue 50 liters. And then what happens? This is known as what? We are expensing out 50 liters of kerosene actually. Asset item is getting expensed out onto a maintenance expense subinventory actually. So that is used for what? Lubrication and then cleaning and then other activities on the furnace actually. These 50 liters. So this transaction is known as what? Asset into expense subinventory. That is the second one. Then what happens? Steel billets are coming. And then this is an asset item. And then that is getting charged into the furnace. So is it asset into asset? So we have a packing steel ropes. Fine. For what happens? Binding it actually. Fine. This is an expense item. And then once when it is rolled, what happens? It will be what happens? Tying it actually. So we'll now tie these steel rods with the steel ropes actually. So this is an expense item into asset. This is the third transaction. The expense item into an asset subinventory. Rolling mill is an asset. Now, whenever a new employee is going to be hired, right? When a new employee is getting hired, so what happens? We will be buying laptops, suitcases, and then we'll be giving it to him actually. And remember, these items are not going to contribute onto my rolling activity. Rolling mill activity is not contributing at all. So they are all known as the expense item. So item by nature is not asset or expense. But even by cost also, it is not an expense. But by real usage only, we will not decide. In a laptop manufacturing company, laptop will be an asset item. Whereas in a steel rolling mill, laptop is an expense item. So the asset or expense item decides upon the usage, what are you doing? And then we'll have a new hire stocking, which is an expense subinventory. So expense item into expense subinventory is the fourth type of transaction actually. Then afterwards, what happens? The stationaries, which are now pen, paper, pencil, etc., they're all expense items. And then they will be tracked onto a non-tracked subinventory. Non-tracked. That means what? The subinventory will not say how much of stock is there on this. So this is called expense into a non-tracked subinventory. That is the fifth one. So on an industry, what happens? These are the five transactions which will happen actually. So we are going to see tomorrow. Right? So what happens? Yeah, the company will now like to have a different charge account for every one of them. For all these things, what happens, the company would like to have a different charge account that comes under purchasing accounting. So in a financial accounting, we will now push the transactions of inventory into what? The cost accounting model and then to the financial accounting model. Whereas in a purchasing accounting, we will not push anywhere else. We will now only analyze the accounts. It will never go into finance at all. The purchasing accounting will never go into financials. And then that will be used for analyzing the what happens accounts actually. So this we are going to see tomorrow. This portion you get. Any doubts on this, my friend? And then the final portion, yeah. Fine, is one, the hospital supplies, I'll be explaining it after I complete this one. Good.
Yeah, Nana, so
tell me.
From terminology, right? So this asset is basically a stocked item. It's not like fixed asset.
No, it is not a fixed asset actually.
Okay.
Fixed assets and then enterprise assets are totally different. Thank you. There are so many things. No. The fixed assets will be dealt by the financials model. Enterprise assets will be dealt by the EAM model. Enterprise asset management. So this is an overview on the what happens, the five types of transactions which take place in purchasing actually. So this is known as a purchasing accounting. So I will be explaining this tomorrow. This is not financial accounting, remember. This will have no impact on the financial accounting. It is a very complex topic. Fine. You will be finding it very difficult to understand. Now, a significant amount of time has gone now. Fine. So what happens? I go there. I will now log in now. Fine. So by this time, what happens if the got done? Fine, click on sign in. And go there. You know, signing in. So we are signing in now. Fine, go there. Come on. We will now go to the what happens item and then we'll now query the item. So we'll now click on the star icon. I go to the product information management. I go there and click on it. I will now go to the browse items and then query my T0101. I go to the browser. I'm trying to go there. The T0101. So go there. So click on search. You're searching for it. Fine. Click on the hyperlink of it. I go to the associations and go to the associations and then here go to the actions and then go to select that. I will now put T011 and then query for it. You select it and then click on apply and then click on done. You do not have a permission to assign that. So this if this comes again now, fine, go there. So even after this, what happens is no coming. So what you have to do is what? You go to the right click and then duplicate. You have to go to the right click and then duplicate. And then here, what happens? You go to the manage item class. You go to the setup and maintenance. And then you go there. You go to the manage item class. This is normally not required actually, fine, but sometimes it is asking for. You go to the place, fine, click on search. You now go to the what? Manage percentage. Item percentage. Class percentage. Manage item classes. So in the manage item classes, what happens? I will now go there. I will now choose my what happens my automotive. I will now select it and then click on edit. Automotive, I'm not sorry because I'm not choosing the root item class, I'm not choosing the automotive. Fine, click
on the reason is because the public is not enabled.
Exactly.
When you enable public, right? So yeah, this kind of access is not
required. One second. The public is not enabled, very correct. If you go to the root item class, what happens? You can now see if you edit it, what happens? The public is enabled actually. It is also not enabled. Fine with that. So there is something I have forgotten it actually. This portion, I will not try to find out on the data. There is something on the public actually. You go to the automotive, fine with that. Click on edit now. And click on edit. Now go there.
See, so public is enabled, you don't have to add security.
Exactly. Yeah, maybe. Very correct. Now. Fine. If public is enabled, security is not required. Fine with that. So now what I do is I go to the item management. And then have a look at it, fine, go there. So it is user defined, and then no enable, fine. These two things must be off now, fine. I will now go to the security. So let me add the security over here now. Thank you. I will now add the security. So click on plus. So I'm now adding it, fine. If public is enabled, then I think the security is not required, fine. Now whatever, I'm not going to give a security. This is called function security and data security. Fine, click on plus. I will now put the product data steward. And then give it out. So product data steward, fine. Use ORA. There are multiple things are coming. Choose the ORA now, fine. Product data steward of ORA you had to choose. Fine, ORA you choose it. EGA, don't choose it now, fine. So this is a different one. Fine, this is the one now. This is a copy only. This is only a copy. So this is using the original, fine. ORA you choose. And then here, I will now put my organization now, fine. Go there. It is a T011. This is the organization I'm putting it. So your function security has been given, for which I'm now going to add a data security also. And select it. And then we had added data security. In the bottom, what happens, you can now see we have selected line. So it now comes with the product data steward for T011. So this information has to come over here first of all. When you choose the line, when you choose the line, it has to come over here. Here you go to actions and then go to select and add. You go to actions and then select and add. And then search for it. Make a blank search on this. Actions, select and add, make a blank search. Thank you, search. Blank search you make it. And then choose all. We have to choose all. By the side of the actions, there is a daba. If you click on the daba, all of them will be chosen in one go, actually. By the side of the actions, there is a daba. If you click on it, all of them get selected. And click on apply and then click on OK. So by which, what happens, we are now given the what's called the data security also. For this one, the function security and data security have been given. So give a save and close. This is sufficient, actually. As somebody was saying, that what happens if you go there and then click on it. So if what happens if you click on it, if the tick mark is there on the public, then what happens? This security is not required at all. The function security and data security is not required at all. Fine. I don't know how to make it enabled. Fine. I'm not very sure about it, but I did it sometime back, but I've forgotten it actually. Now you go to the browse items and then go to the actions and go to select that. You'll now add the item. So select it and then select it and then click on apply and then click on done. Now fine. Now it will get added. So we are now given the function security and data security for the child R. And remember, only after you give the product data steward role actually. But this is not required for certain item classes actually, where the public is enabled. The function security and data security. Right? So if somebody knows anything on this, now fine, please educate all of us. Now fine. I know that, but I've forgotten it actually. Otherwise, if you add the role, that is more than sufficient to add your organization actually. Add the role itself will not sufficient because that is normally coming as a security is normally coming as bypassed actually. If anybody knows it, please educate all of us about how to do this. No, fine. I've forgotten actually. I did it 1 year back when I was doing it. I was remembering it, but I forgot it. So the item is now assigned to the child org also. Got it? No, fine. Click on save and close.
No, can you just write one through the task, manage default item where there is one more task?
Oh, yeah, that is also there, but I don't know that. No. Good one. There is one, manage default item class is also there. Fine. Somebody please make an R&D on this about how to bypass this function security and data security. Please educate all of us so that we'll learn it now. Fine. Because we cannot do it when you're having hundreds of organizations. We cannot give function security and data security for each and every org. We have to bypass that. How to do that? Fine. Just try. If you succeed on it, please educate all of us now. Fine. But one of my students taught me that 1 year back when I was conducting this training, he taught me, but I have forgotten and note it down actually. That's all gone now. If you know it, please educate us. That was an Oracle training, not a normal public batch actually. So I was conducting a training for Oracle actually. So that guy was knowing the product data hub also very nicely. He was educating us about how to, because function security and data security for every org, if you have 150 orgs, do you know how much of difficult exercise it is? It's a very difficult exercise actually. Okay, fine. Now Adam is assigned. Fine, click on now. Now we are going to perform a miscellaneous transaction. So once when you perform a miscellaneous receipt, what happens? There are two accounts which are hit now. One is what? The inventory valuation will be hit on the debtor side, and then your offset account will be hit on the creditor side. Fine. Debtor side, you'll be having inventory valuation account, and on the creditor side, the offset account will be hit. Fine. So these are the only two accounts which are going to be hit for the miscellaneous receipt actually. So let us go there. Fine. Let us now perform a miscellaneous receipt. We'll not go there. I will not go to the what? I will not go there. Click on it. I will not go to the supply chain execution, and then I go to the inventory management, and then let us now perform what happens this thing. So the org has to change. I will not click on it. So we have to change the org. Click on it. We'll now go to the what? Create miscellaneous transaction. I go there and then change the org. So click on change org and then change it to what? Mine. So T011. We have already given the data access. So which data access is now bringing in now? Fine. There are four data access there. Inventory, receiving agent, warehouse manager, shipping manager. Which is responsible for change of this org? Anybody?
Inventory manager.
Inventory manager is very correct. Inventory manager responsibility, my inventory manager data access is responsible for performing a miscellaneous transaction basically. Good, good, good. So Lingeshwari has now become an expert now. Fine, click on it. So go there, drop it down. I will now choose the miscellaneous receipt. So in the account, whatever they go there, I will drop down. This is called the offset account. Fine, click on search. I will not choose this now. Fine, click on it. Click on OK. I'm not choosing anything like that. So let me take a copy of the offset account. Fine. This will be coming on the accounting front now. Fine. So click on it. I will now make a notepad now. So that will be coming on the account. Fine. This is the offset account. Offset is what? This one. So this will be coming on the whatever your inventory valuation to offset. So offset is not done. So I'm not going to choose the current item cost. Whatever. I will not choose what? No, no. Fine. I'm going to give a transactional cost now. I will not give a no now. Fine. So click on plus no. Fine. I will not put the item over there. So the item is what? T0101. Fine, go there. It is a T0101 and then give a tap. I know I'm putting it. Fine, go there. So we have got only one sub inventory in this org. Fine, that will be coming up automatically. So drop it down. I will not choose the sub inventory. So if the item is not visible, you can even expand this field and then you can now see it now. Right, still not visible. Fine, expand it. No coming. So click on the edit details.
Nana?
I tell me.
Nana, we have created this item newly, right? Then. Okay.
When you create the item newly, the asset cost profile has got attached to this item automatically.
Yeah, but why do we need to say do not use item?
Because cost? Item is not having any cost at all. If you transact it, it will now go as a zero cost only. When item as and when it creates, it will be having a zero cost only. So
but
now
the cost. Nana, but the cost profile you attached is an average costing, so you don't need average cost.
Yeah.
So whatever cost you're going to put in.
Yeah. We are going to see this. We are going to see this. We are going to see the average costing. So click on it. You're going to see this. So item is coming. Fine. Go there. So the enter cost details is not coming because the quantity is not put. Go there. I will not put the quantity as 100. 100 cost. No. Then this will be getting enabled. Fine. Click on it. So what are all the components which will be flowing in? Anybody? There are two components we are going to fold now. What are the components? Anybody?
Item price.
Item price and non-recoverable tax, exactly. And go there. I will not choose the item price. It says item price is $10. And go there. And then plus, and then what happens? You'll be having what? Your non-recoverable tax, right? $1. So these two components will now flow, and then they already have a mapping. The mapping is already there on a mapping set. Fine, go there. On the cost profile, we've already given the mapping set. Yeah.
Now I have a question here. On this non-recoverable tax, probably, you know, you're trying to enter the cost, but then if the tax engine is set up, the tax is going to come from there.
How does that is saying that matter? This will be coming from the tax setups, actually. I don't know how it's all done now, fine. If it is going
for
tax setups, fine. I don't know how it will be coming, fine. That you would only learn from Tijil. Fine. So if tax setups are also there, then what happens, your fusion tax, then what happens, he's saying that you will not be entering in, it will be coming from that tax setups automatically. Okay, fine. So now you are given an item price of what? $11. No, fine. Click on OK. So click on OK, and then click on OK, and then submit it. So 100 quantities at $11 is going to glow, is now getting transacted. No, fine. Click on submit. So once when the transaction is now complete, we are now going to push this transaction to the costing area. We are now going to perform a pushing of this transaction to the costing area now. On the functional security and data security of the R, fine. If anybody knows it, please educate us. No, fine. But you want to learn it, I've forgotten it actually. Now, what happens? We're going to push it now. Fine. So I'll now go there. Right click and then duplicate now. Fine. Always right click and then duplicate and then do it now. Fine. Click on duplicate. And then here, what happens? I'm going to push it now. Fine. Click on it. So let us now run the scheduled process now. Fine. Go there. Go to the tools. I will now go to the tools. I will now push it into the interface tables of costing now. Fine. Click on tools. And then I go to the schedule process. And then let me add it to the favorites actually. So go to the favorites and then let me add to the favorites. I add to favorites and then let us now add the schedule monitor process. Fine, click on save and close. So let us now push this transaction to the costing area for costing it now. Fine, click on schedule. So the transaction is already done for $11. We'll now push it now. Fine, it's called transfer. Fine, transactions from inventory to costing. So transfer transactions from inventory to costing is the one. Fine, it can be in capital. If we give it a tab, whatever the minimum. Transfer transactions from inventory to costing, it will be pushing into the interface tables of costing directly. Fine. So whatever transactions have been done, fine, click on it. So click on OK. But you cannot run it manually every time. The cost org is what T01. So what it will do is, it will now schedule this task now. Fine. This ESS job will be scheduled. Fine. You go to the advanced. Fine. Go to the advanced. And then we will not schedule it. Fine. Go to the schedule now. Fine. Fine. Go there. Using a schedule. Fine. Go there. It will not say what happens. How early? So go there. I will not say every 2 hours it has to. And then give a start date and then end date also. If you give an end date as what? As a blank or a very high date, what happens? It will be running continuously actually. Fine, go there. So give it. Fine, go there. So I will not remove this. Fine. I will not say 25 or 26. Up to 26 will be running. So every 2 hours it will be running. And then whatever transactions have happened in the past 2 hours, they will all be pushed into the costing area continuously. So these concurrents will be scheduled actually. You cannot run it manually, remember. It's very impossible. So using a schedule, we'll be running it. So the frequency will now vary from company to company. How frequently you want to run, they will now vary. Because the number of transactions is more than what, you'll be running it very frequently. Fine, click on submit. So it'll now run once, and then afterwards, it'll be getting scheduled, actually. Fine. It'll now run once, no, fine. So go there. So it'll now run once, and then it'll now get scheduled automatically. So go there. You're not going to run now. So transfer transactions into inventory costing, what happens, you know, what happens, one for the scheduled one. Another one is what, they're not going to run now. No going to run. So once when it's completed, what happens, you go there. We can even search on the user which has run it actually, fine. Submitted by SCM10 actually. Full name is not required, fine, click on search. Fine, click on search, it will show you. Whatever SCM10 has run, it will be coming. So it's still in the wait status actually. So go there. So once when it runs, what happens? It will be one of them will be completed, and then after 2 hours, the next one will be running actually. So in the meantime, what happens? We have to bring it from the interface tables of costing to the base tables of costing, for which what happens? The periods has to be open. So if you see this now, fine, click on it. If you see this, we'll now go there. We'll now go to this place. Fine. I will now open up my product data hub. I will now open up my this thing now. Fine. Go to the instances file. So here, what happens? We will now try to open up a financial what happens? This, you know, FAS01. I will now open it up. And then there we can see the general ledger period whether it is open or not. Right? So let me first of all reset the FAS01 password for this. No, fine, click on it. We'll not go there. So we'll not, first of all, reset the password for this. So go there. Not. It's still waiting now. I don't know why it's still waiting, waiting. Come on here. Or otherwise it must have got completed. We are only run the SCM10 only run these three concurrents. So I will now go there, click on it. I will now click on it. I will now go to the security console first of all, and then I will now reset the FA01 and dot student. Go to the security console. I will now reset the FA01 now. Fine, go to the users now. Fine, click on the FA01. So go there. FA01 dot student. This is a financial user actually. Go there. So let them all reset the password so that what happens, we can very well log in with this now and click on it. So go to the reset password of the FA01 now. Fine, go there. So I will not make it as what? Welcome on 234. So we have to first of all open the GL period, and then afterwards only we can open the costing period. Remember, I click on reset. So we are resetting it. What happens? Welcome 1234. So it's caps basically, W caps. Now we're getting it. Now I will now take up a copy of this. It is the FA01. I will now open up a Edge browser, and then I will now open it up. I will now open up Edge browser. Click on Edge browser. So click on it. I will now paste it over here. Click on it. I will now log in as what? FA01.student. It is FA01.student. It is welcome 1234. Fine, we'll go there. Let us now open up the GL period actually. Oh god, what happened? FAS01.student. Welcome 1234. Now it's accepting it. So we'll now go to the GL, and then what happens, I have a look at it. If I click on the home icon here in the top, I will now go to the GL. Go there. General accounting. General accounting will be available only on a financial login now. If I click on it. And then I go to the period close. If I click on the period close. So if you go to the period close, what happens, we can set up our data access set. So go down. It is the US primary ledger, remember. So choose the US primary ledger for the data access set, and then click on OK. That will be coming on the return set top. US primary ledger. So here, GL is already open actually. Otherwise, what you have to do is you have to click on the GL and then open the periods. Fine. You choose anything, and then what happens, you have to open the periods. Now, up to 324 is now, what happens, this is future interval now. The future interval, let me try to open it up. Fine. So 324, go to actions, and then go to open the target period. And then go down and then choose what? 324. So 324, I'm going to choose it. So 324, I'm choosing it. So 324 will be open. If I click on open. And then this action will open the periods up to the target period, actually. And remember, we cannot do the opening of the periods up to target period in costing. We can only open one by one. Whereas here, we can even choose a higher period. 325 also, you can choose. All the periods can be opened together in one shot, actually. Whereas that facility is not available in costing. So this is not, fine. Your process is now submitted. Fine, go there. So go there. So since somebody has already opened the 224, what happens if we need an outdoor? So it is not running, fine. You give a refresh now. This refresh is also not available in costing now. This refresh is also not available. So 324 will be getting open now. Fine, now in the future interval. So we are now already submitted. Then now and now see after some time what happens. So first thing is what? We had to open up your GL period for the current month actually. You had to open. Well, you see, 324 has got open. The fourth is now future interval actually. So if you give 12 months as a target period, if you go to the actions and then go to open target period, and then here, whatever, you go there, drop it down, and then choose a higher one. Now, frankly, on it. If you choose what? 24. And then if you choose whatever the higher period now, say 326, and then give open. All the periods up to March 26 will be open in one go, whereas that is not possible in costing. Costing, we had to open only one by one, remember. Fine. Well, what else? And then remember, in the inventory and purchasing, do not have any periods at all. So first of all, ensure that your GL period for the month of February, the month we are working, is open. Then afterwards, what happened? They will not open the payables period. They will not open the receivables period. Then go there, projects period, and then assets. All these things they will open. But costing, we had to open separately. It cannot be done from here. Costing cannot be opened from here. What happens? We had to open it up separately. Clear on this now, fine. So first, ensure that the GL period is open. The GL only open, then only we can open the costing period. Otherwise, it's not possible. Anybody can say yes to me that you understood it? Good. Fine. So now, yes. Whatever, we'll now come back to ours. Now, thank you, Conrad. We'll now go to this place, monitor process, and then click on it. Now, what happens? Transfer transaction, the inventory costing is succeeded, actually. Fine. One of them has succeeded. The other one are all waiting, actually. They are already planned for the different timing. 3:37, it is 5:35, maybe 3:33 we might run it. So after 2 hours, 5:33 is going to run, actually. So this will be running, and then again, what happens, the next one will be 7:33. Like that, what happens, it will be getting scheduled. So we will always schedule all the CSS jobs on the costing area to run on a periodic basis, actually. Clear? So this is no success. Now, it has now reached the, what happens, the costing area, actually. The data has now come to the costing area. Now, let us know, first of all, the first activity is to what? Open the costing period. No, fine. You go there, right-click and then duplicate. No, fine. Go there, right-click and then duplicate. We will now open up the costing period. No. Go there. So I will now go to what? Inventory. No. I will now go to what? We will now click on this. I will now go to what? We are not added it. No, fine. Go there. So we will now, first of all, add it. Go there. So go there. Click on it. We will now go to the what? Inventory. Fine. Go to the supply chain execution. No, fine. Go there. You go to the supply chain execution. Supply chain execution. And then here, I go to the cost accounting now. Supply chain execution and cost accounting, I'm going to go there now. It has now reached the interface tables of cost accounting area. Fine, click on it. I'm not going over there. So let me add it now. Fine, click on it. I'll now add it. Go to add to favorites. Fine, go there. Come on. And then I will now say cost overview. Fine. I will now make a change of this. Fine, click on several tools. Now, we will now see the inventory valuation. Now. Fine, go there. So drop it down. Click on it. And then drop down and then choose your cost or no. So choose your cost or and then click on apply. So for this cost or, what is the total valuation here now? Fine, nothing is there. Because the data of $11 for 100 quantities has reached only the interface tables and not the base tables actually. So once when it reaches the base table, this value will be coming up now. So the first activity on the costing area is what? Open periods. Fine. Click on the task list and then go there. And then go to the manage cost accounting periods. You go to the manage cost accounting periods. So for the prerequisite is what? The GL should have been open now. Fine, click on it. The prerequisite is what? GL should have been open. So let us now search for it. Now, fine. I will now say the cost talk starts with the T01. So T01 is the one. Fine. Give a search now. Fine. We are going to search for it. We are now searching for it. So once when you search for it, it is not coming. So here, what happens? It says the thing now. Fine. The current period 224 is not open. The prior period 124 is also not open. The next period 324 is also not open. Fine. So go there. I will now go to actions and then what happens? Open target period. Here, one by one only we can open. Remember, we cannot open up to 12 months or 2 years or 3 years now. Where costing period can be open only one by one. Just like in EBIS, we can open the inventory periods only one by one. So here also, the costing periods can be opened only one by one. Inventory do not have any periods. Purchasing do not have any periods, remember. Open target period. Only one by one you can open now. So 124, I'm now going, click on, okay, now fine. Now 121, the prior period will be getting open. You know, got open now, fine, got open. Now the current period will open now, fine. Go to actions, and then what happens, you go to the open target period. The current period is coming, fine, click on, okay. The current period will be open now. Fine, also. If you want, you can open the next period also. Open target period, you can even open the next period. Similarly, what happens, you can even keep on opening. Fine, go to actions, and then go to open target period. I will now say fourth one, fine. You can keep on opening one by one actually. So the period opening activity is complete. It is all open. Any doubts? Next is what? We are going to bring in the data from the interface tables of cost accounting into the base tables of cost accounting. This activity is known as what? Distribution creation, actually. Costing distribution creation. So we are now going to bring the data from the interface tables of costing into the base tables of costing. This is known as a cost accounting distributions now. This is known as cost accounting distribution. So we are now creating the cost accounting distributions by doing it now. Fine. So click on it. I will now go there. So I will now click on the task list and then go there. I will now go then create the cost accounting distributions. So go to this area. Fine. After open the period, what happens? You click on the create cost accounting distribution. So click on the create cost accounting distribution. Fine. Go there. Click on it. I will now go there. I will now click on plus now. Fine. First activity is to create a run control. So this is called run control. My click on plus and then it has now created a run control action. So the run control is what? T01. I will now say run underscore control. And then enable the cost processor reporting also. Right? Enable the cost processor reporting. So the run control will have this thing now. Fine. What are the details of the run control now? Fine. The bottom, whatever we'll be having it. So go there. Go to actions and then go to add row. We are going to add row. The cost org is what? T01. Give a tab. And then the cost book is what? T01. Give a tab. The ledger is coming. Fine. Go there. Is a user defined. And then normally what happens up to the month end, we'll have a cutoff date. All the transactions up to February end, we will be performing the distribution. Right? We are creating the distribution. If I click on it, I will now say whatever the 29th of this month. We normally use what? We can even use any date also. So up to month end, whatever transactions have happened, right? Whatever transactions happen. So all the data which has now reached the interface tables of cost accounting will be brought into the base tables of cost accounting, and then that is called distribution creation action. So give a save now. At this stage, whatever they give a save, and then run the scheduled process. So we have created a run control with all the four cost processes. Pre-processor, cost processor, COGS recognition, cost distribution, and then the reporting also we enabled. And then this is specific for cost or cost book. And then up to a certain cutoff date actually. Fine. They will now put a cutoff date and then do it. And then click on the schedule process. This is going to be a big concurrent now. It will not take run approximately for 2 minutes now. Schedule process I'm running into. So the distributions are getting created. There are no parameters for this. Whatever has reached the interface tables of cost accounting, everything will be pulled into the base tables. No, frankly, on submit. All of them will be pulled in one go. No, frankly, on it. No, running. Go there. So, go there. So, and then have a look at the concurrent.
Nana, can we leave the cutoff date blank also?
I don't know. It's a good question. Whether we leave it blank or not, you talk to the finance. And again, this will also be running on a periodic basis. You will be scheduling it. This concurrent will be scheduled. Create cost accounting distributions will be scheduled because we cannot manually run anything at all in the area. Everything will be scheduled actually to run on a periodic basis. So this concurrent normally takes around 2 minutes. So every half an hour or 1 hour or 2 hour, whatever way you want, you schedule this concurrent actually. Every ESS job on the costing area will be scheduled actually. Whatever we are running it, everything will be scheduled actually.
Yeah, Nana, in this period open and these things, there are also no SCM responsibilities versus finance.
There is no SCM responsibility. We have a cost accountant role, actually. We don't have any responsibility. Okay. It's a role-based role. Right? The cost accountant role and then the cost setups are responsible for it.
Okay.
And remember, everything will be running on a periodic basis. Nobody can run it manually at all. It will all run on its own, actually. They will not set it for next 2 years and then they will all run. This is a big concurrent. It will not take a longer time actually. So once when this is completed, what happens? You can now see the data coming on the base tables. I will now give a save and close on the run control actually. Save and close on the run control. And then we will now have a look at the distributions now. We will now review the distribution now. So this is also done now. Fine. The period is open. I will now go there and then review the distribution. So we will now go to the what? Review cost accounting distribution, which has now come into the base tables. Now, thank you. This is the one on the cost processing. You go to the review cost accounting distribution. You go to the review cost distribution. I will now say cost star starts with whatever it is, the T01 now, right? T01, and then item starts with T01 now, and then click on search. So that 2 minute concurrent, if it is completed, it will be coming. Now, thank you. On search, so click on search. Now, fine, you know, searching, whatever it is. Come. It is yet to come. Cut the transaction date is on or after only. It's okay. Then click on search. So it takes some time now. Fine. Sometimes what happens, this search will not be working properly. So you give the full name of the cost star. Fine. Cost star, sometimes what happens with the part name, it is not working. Fine. I will not put the full name now. Fine. Sometimes it is required actually. Full name, you have to give it to the cost star only. And then click on search. If the partial is not coming, you give the full name, it will come now actually. Even though we are going to start with, fine. It doesn't come properly at all. It takes a long time. Right? It's the first time you're running it. Now, fine, go there. So it takes a long time. So the distributions can be reviewed over here. You go to the monitoring process. Right? Cost, great cost accounting distributions is not succeeded actually. So this is not succeeded actually. Go there. Now we'll now go there and then review it. Now, fine, click on this review. Ah, oh, it's not coming. So cost of items, whatever, you know, say T0101. underscore cost underscore test. Find this item off. I click on search. So click on search. Oh God, it is still not coming. Any mistakes here? E0101. I will now remove the item and then make a test now. Thank you. Sometimes it takes a long time for the thing to realize actually in this place. Actually. So click on done. I will now log out and log in and then come back. Sign out and sign in. Now you go there and then I'll now go to the costing area, costing overview. So choose your org now. If I click on it, choose your org. And then we will now refresh it and then see whether the asset value has now come on or not. So click on refresh now. If it is successful, you will now see the inventory asset valuation coming up. Asset valuation has not come. We'll now go to the monitor process and then see when create cost accounting distributions is there now. But play costing integration. We will now try to see what has gone wrong actually. Transfer transactional inventory costing has succeeded. Fine. We will now create the cost accounting distribution spend. We'll be able to see this amount, you know, because of inactivity, the screen has. Oh. Now go there. Click on the scheduled process. Now it's monitor process. Cost accounting distribution has succeeded. We'll now try to read this value. Click on this file. Open up this one. No errors or warning. Transaction processed successfully is zero actually. Why it is so? So let us now again push it and then what happens? Do the cost distribution creation actually. Anybody is able to understand this now? It has no process, nothing actually.
I think, can you look at the submit financial orchestration events that has errored out? I think that is a...
Submit financial events.
Yeah, you can look at the log, what happened.
Click on it. And then we go on and click on the attachments. They're now giving the same error. So submit financial orchestration event has been entered now.
Yeah, batch size is one. That means somebody has set up the financial orchestration for...
Oh, God. If people are doing so many other things now, it will be very, very difficult, actually.
So, generally, if you don't set up the financial orchestration, the events, trade events in financial orchestration, system won't kick off that process at all.
Oh, that so process itself will not be kicked off, you're saying, no?
Yeah.
Anyhow, I will not do one thing, fine. I will now again transfer transactions from whatever they go there. Transfer. Fine. Let us now see the stock now, fine. We'll now see whether the stock has now come or not. Fine, click on it. I will now go to this place. Fine, click on it. I will now go on and have a look at the stock now. Fine, click on it. I will now go to what product information monitor over there. I will now click on it. I will now go to the inventory. Fine. I will now go to the inventory and then see whether the stock is there or not. Fine, first of all. Supply chain execution, and then I go to the inventory management. So let me also add to the favorites. I click on it. Add to favorites. It is the inventory overview. Click on second closer. Now have a look at the stock. Now I click on it. Go to the manage item quantities. But the T0101, and then give it tab. Item itself is not coming over. The organization is
inventory organization.
Change org. Now I click on it. Hello. Chain the org. It is a T011. Go there. Click on OK. So click on it. We'll go on and go to the manage item quantities. No, thank you. It is a T0101 and then give it tab. So click on search. No, we have the on-end. On-end is perfectly available. So we'll now go there and I will now run again. If I click on a scheduling process, fine. Transfer transactions from inventory to costing. I ran it as a what? As a scheduled process, actually. Right? Transfer transactions from inventory to costing. This time, I'm not running it as a scheduled process. And keep a search now. Something.
Nana, this has to run like before opening of costing period or after opening of costing period?
Before opening the costing. This is only pushing it to the interface tables. No?
Okay.
Interface tables means what? Costing period has got nothing to do at all. So you give the cost star and click on submit now. Right? I have given the cost org or not, I have a doubt now. Right? I might have run it without the cost org actually. This parameter might not have been submitted in the last one. I have a doubt now. Because I don't remember I have given that. So that may be the problem. I might have missed the cost org actually. That may be the reason. So this will run fast actually. If I have now got completed. Then afterwards, what happens? I will now go to the costing area and if I click on it, I'll go to the inventory manager. So click on it. I will know what happens to run it. I will now do the create the distribution directly. So go there. So click on the star icon. I go to the cost overview. Fine. Let us know what I think I have forgotten the cost org actually as a parameter. The parameter has to be passed. I might have forgotten it. So create cost accounting distributions for it. Click on it. We'll now go on and create a cost accounting distribution. So we'll now query the current control of T01. And then click on search. Now, if I click on search, it will be coming out. You know that. So everything is there. So let us now schedule the process. Click again on the schedule process. This will now run for 2 minutes actually. 6100 is the concurrent. Over there. So this is one. So once the concurrent is completed, then what happens? Create cost accounting distribution. I must have forgotten the cost or parameter. That is what I failed. While explaining it, what happens? I might have forgotten it actually. Meantime, what happened? Long over the click on that. Long over the cost. Oh, you can click on it. So click on the star and then go to the cost overview. Review the cost accounting distribution. View cost accounting distribution. And it starts with, I will now say it, the T01 underscore cost underscore R. Item starts with and T01. So click on search, no, fine, click on search. It's come. Oh, I have forgotten it actually. That is my mistake actually. Right, that is my mistake. So I have forgotten to pass on the parameter of cost on. That is why it has not come. It is now fully costed, but it is not yet accounted actually. It's a miscellaneous reserve, fine, go that to it, no coming. So the transaction cost is zero, fine, go that. So it's a miscellaneous reserve. It will not give you the reference number. All these things, it will not give you everything. What is your asset valuation unit, fine? What is the date of cost? What is the cost profile it has used? Everything it will not give you. Are you all clear? Somebody can say yes to me. Now, we have to do the accounting now. It is not an accountant. Right? We have to do the accounting. Okay? Hello? Somebody can say yes to me?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So now, what happens? We have to account it. I have not passed on the cost org, actually. Now, we go there. We will now perform the create accounting now. So now, what happens? One of the account is already there now. If you go there, click on it. So we have an account of what? Opposite account. So the opposite account is what? 15925. So if you click on the view details, it will not show you. If I click on it, if you click on the view details, it will not show you the account. Inventory valuation to offset actually. If I click on the view valuation, fine, go there. So if you go to the cost information, fine, go there. So the total cost is 10 plus 1, $11. If you go to the cost distribution, fine, click on the cost distribution, it will not show you the distributions. So it is not done, fine. So it debit, fine. Valuation is debited and then the offset is credited actually. These are the two values. Right? This is about the $1, $1. Everything is now that everything is created actually. And then if you go to the journal entries are not yet made. If you go to the journal entries, what happens? The journal entries are not yet made. Right? We have to create the journal entries. Nothing is there actually. So in the distribution also, if you go on and see, if you go to the right-hand side, we have the offset account available here, but inventory valuation is not set at all. Inventory valuation is not set. Right? Inventory valuation, the first two are inventory valuation. Fine, go there. So inventory valuation for the what happens your item price and then your what happens your non-recoverable tax for which what happens the inventory valuation is not itself. So this is now coming during transaction. We are given this value, it has now come. Now, if I try to create an accounting, it will now fail on this because inventory valuation is not set. It will not go there. We'll look at the accounting. It'll go there. Click on create accounting. The accounting, what happens? They click on the create accounting. I'm not going to create accounting for this. Cost management fine, go there. It's a US primary ledger. You go there, US primary ledger. I'm going to give it now. Click on. We'll not wait for 10 more minutes and then we'll not try to complete now. 10 more minutes, I will not wait. So go there. I will not go for the deal. Okay, fine. Transfer, GM, fine. Everything is there. Click on, yeah. Click on
the thing. It will fail.
Huh?
This will fail.
Yeah. This will fail. That is what I want to say. This is going to fail actually. Because inventory valuation is not there. So this will be failing actually. This is not going to fail actually. If you go there. So this create accounting will be having a create accounting report also. That will clearly say that what happens, the inventory valuation is not set at all. The create accounting is running fine. So the meantime, what happens, I will now right click and then duplicate. And then I will now set up the inventory valuation account first. So go there. So click on the right hand side star and then go to the setup and maintenance and then come to the FSM area. We are now coming to the FSM area. There, what happens, we are going to set up this one. In the FSM area, what happens, you go there. You go to the manufacturing and supply chain management area and then go to the manage mapping set. Manage percentage fine, mapped percentage fine, set percentage. You go to the manage mapping set of manufacturing and supply chain management area. Here, you go to the cost accounting. Choose the cost accounting. So now the scope is not yet selected again now. Manage mapping set of cost accounting. So click on the scope and then select the cost management. So click on the scope and then select the cost management and drop it down. Select net and then click on apply and go to task. And then here, what happens, you go and then choose the cost management. You choose the cost management. So cost management, I'm choosing it fine. So click on save and close by which, what happens, the cost management is chosen for your manage mapping set. So the manage mapping set of cost management is come fine. Here, we will now set up the inventory valuation account. We're going to set up. So expand the search. And then here you put INV. INV and then make a search. Now, fine, click on search. INV and then make a search. Fine. This is called inventory valuation. So I am going to set it up for my org actually. For my org, I'm going to set up. Fine. So click on the inventory valuation. Fine. So click on the inventory valuation hyperlink. And then we will now set up the inventory valuation account for my org actually. Go on. So there are multiple chart of accounts there. Our account, our chart of accounts is US chart of accounts. Remember, you should never forget your entities at all. Your entities should not be forgotten at all. You must remember every entity. So where is our entities now? But I have closed it or what? I don't know. Where is the file now? The file is not visible at all. So go there. So choose yours this now. Fine. Use color one. So here, what happens? I will now put for my org actually. So let me take up the chart of accounts. Fine. This is the value you're giving. Fine. Click on it. I will now take a copy of it. I will now put it up on my Word file also. Fine. Go there. I will now say here also, what happens? I will now say is the inventory valuation. This will be given by the financial team actually. The inventory valuation I'm going to choose now. So offset is already there. Inventory valuation is already there. Take a copy. So click on plus and then I will add one line. In this line, what happens? The inventory org is not having any list of values. Remember, you have to give it very correctly. If you give it wrongly, it will not come out. Fine. T011. Even if you give a small t, it will not work at all. It must be very correct. The sub inventory must be star. Give a star. And then costing category, you should not put a star, but you have to choose from the list of values actually. Fine. Drop it down and then choose from the list of values. There is a star in the top. Don't put a star manually. Choose it from the list of values. Item number is also star. Sometimes what happens, for each and every item, they may even want a different valuation account, means what you have to set up. That will be a very laborious task. And that's it. Fine. So the inventory valuation for my org for all items is set actually. Any doubt? I set up for all the items. Go there. So click on save and close by which, what happens, is not done. So in the meantime, what happens, you go there and then it will now refresh it. It will now have one create accounting will be having a report also. Execution report is there. Fine. Create accounting execution report. If you click on it and then it will now publish it. Fine, click on it. Now go to publish it. Fine, go down. It will now publish it. So, so output will be coming. We'll be publishing it. Fine. Click on republish on this one. We are going to republish it. So click on the star icon. Export to PDF now. Fine. Export to PDF. You're now going to publish it. Publish. So it's now getting published. So click on it and then open the report now. Fine, click on open the report. So here, if you go down, fine, the create accounting execution report is now coming. Fine, go that, click on it. It will now give you the execution report now. Fine, click on it. So out of which, whatever, you can now see that whatever the US primary ledger is ours now. Fine, go there. So invalid journal entries is one actually. There is one invalid journal entries for the US primary ledger actually. If you go down, there are so many listings are there. If you go there, you can now see what is today's date actually. So today's date is 3/2/24 now. Fine, go there. So here, what happens, you can now see the offset account is coming, but inventory valuation do not have any account at all. So it says what clearly? So it says what? The input source value does not map to any output value for the inventory valuation actually. That is the problem. Okay, fine. It is for 100 and then 1. Fine, go there. So I'm showing you the whole thing. entered values are not shown over here. 1,100, right? So the total value is 1,100. So the inventory valuations are having a problem. Because of which. So go there. So any doubts on this? Fine. Afterwards, what happened? There are so many transactions will be happening now. Fine. So BIP material issue, all these things are coming. Fine. It is all happening in different dates actually. So ours is what? This date, yeah, see. This is all not ours actually. So there are so many things. Okay. So we can even run the report and see it now. Fine. Close. Now what happens? If you go to the what's called your create cost accounting distributions, fine, go there. No, no, fine. Now we'll now make a search again now. Fine, click on search. So previously, what happens? It is not what happens. Not done now. Fine, go there. So now, if you go, then what happens? You give a save and close. Now, fine, click on save and close. And then here, you go there and then review the cost accounting. It will not show an error. Now, you go to the review cost accounting distributions. It will not show an error actually. I will not put what starts with T01. You will not see if it works or not. It will create actually item. What happens? It starts with the T01. Sometimes it doesn't work. Means what? You give something fully. Fine, click on search. It is not working. I will not say whenever I have this error, what happens? I will not put the full cost organized. Now fine, then it works actually. So whether it's not working, fine, click on search. Now fine. Now okay. Fine. So if you put the full cost org, fine, it works actually. I don't know why it's so fine. Select it and then click on the view details. Fine, click on the view details. Fine, go there. In the view details, what happens? You go there and then see the cost distribution. Now fine, click on the cost distribution. Fine, you know, having all these things. And again, what happens? The inventory valuation has not come. Fine, you go to the transactional errors. Fine, go there. Click on transactional errors. Go there. So there is no errors at all. If you go to the journal entries, what happens? You'll be having the error actually. The journal entries will be having it. So go there. So one is what? Miscellaneous receipt. Now fine, go there. So if the miscellaneous receipt for inventory valuation, go there. If you expand it, it will not show you. No, click on expand it. It will not show you. The input source does not have a valuation by what is not showing. And then this is for the offset actually. So this is for the offset. When both of them are coming as a class as inventory valuation. So the journal entries are having error now. Fine. So now we have set up this account. What happens? We will again, what happens? Do the create accounting now. So we'll now again perform the create accounting. Fine, go there. So click on it. We will now perform the create accounting again. Fine, click on it. We'll now go there. Click on create accounting. We are now corrected the error. We have now set up the inventory valuation account. Fine, go there. US primary ledger. Fine, enter in. US primary ledger. Go there. Fine, go there. Fine. I will now make it to the detail now. Fine, go there. SS. This time it will be creating the journal entry and then it will now post into the GL also because posting is also enabled. Transfer to GL as well as posting. Now, since there is no error, what happens? It will be creating the journals. Fine. The transactional journals will be created in the financial accounting. And then it will be posted also for what happens, taking your profit and loss and balance sheet actually. So posting also will happen. Thank you, Consolidate. If there is no error on the inventory valuation. Thank you, Consolidate. We'll now go on and have a look at it. So this time you can now see a lot of things are running now. Create accounting. Please wait for some 10-15 minutes now because what happens tomorrow, if this again goes away, it will be very difficult for me to simulate actually. Let me do everything in one go now actually. Now you can see the post of the subledger journals is now running. Previously, it was not running. Fine. Post of subledger journals is not running. So it's not running. It is now posting it to GL actually. It is now what happens, the posting it to GL. Post subledger journal entries and all that, you know, getting posted. So once when it is posted, we can very well take the profit and loss and balance sheet. Fine. Whenever you want to it. So the posting happens only when the inventory valuation is there in place, actually. Credit accounting is not running. It is not entering the warning. I don't know what is the warning, actually. What is the review cost accounting? So click on, again, search. Now, fine, click on search again. And then click on the view details. Fine. It is not entered in the error, actually. Fine. It is not entered in the error. Fine. Click on the error. So what is the error? I don't know what is the error, actually. If you click on the view details, you will not see this. Here it is. Go there. So go there again. Miscellaneous receipt. Go there.
No, sir. Again, query it that.
Oh, what happens? I will know. Done and then I will not re-query it. Now, maybe a previous record. No, I will go there. So we'll now go to the review cost accounting distribution and not re-query it. Now. So starts with go there. The T01 underscore cost underscore org. I will now say it starts with. The T01. So click on search. See, it's still error only. Click on view details. The error. If you go to the journal entries now, click on the journal entries. Oh, God. Now it's all done. Here, journal entries, everything has come up properly. So there's one, you know, see, there is no red mark at all. There is no red mark at all. Previously, red mark was there, fine, it's not there. So go there. So both the, for item price, what happens, it has not given these two things. And then this is the offset account. Fine. One for the valuation and then one for the offset. All the accounts are there in place, actually. So this is the account now, fine. This is the account. So you can see 22210, fine. 10110. We'll now see whether the account which is given or fine. So it is now giving a different account, actually. Fine. The inventory valuation is this amount. This I have entered it there, but we got a different account here now. Here this account is coming, see, 14100 for the item is now coming properly, 141, and then for the offset it is now taken up a different account. This is offset account. Offset it is now taken a different account. Oh god, this is really very difficult one. We can't understand it just like that, actually. So Tijil will be even discussing a lot on this.
No, sir, that would have been an overridden, eh? So
overridden means what?
So there are override rules, right?
So you have override roles, and then whatever said that has overridden it to this value, actually.
There are multiple ways to, you know, get the accounts. And the invalid, you can see, right? This is because the second, you can click on the ledger, the drop down.
On the drop down?
Just above the accounting button. Ledger. Just above.
Just above
this one, yeah. Yeah, click on the second one.
USRC.
This is error of this region.
You
can see all these are in error.
Conversion rate from USD to UR, fine, is the conversion. Yeah. We have never done any conversion. We have done everything on USD only.
correct. Because for Feb, right? So it's basically what is happening is trying to convert from primary ledger to secondary ledger, which is in Euro.
You can see.
So its system is asking for the currency to be set up as well.
So somebody is also doing a lot of setups on the system. And so what happens, finally, we have landed up on some errors on the currency conversions, actually. They have not done it because of it. So we have to watch it via this, actually. On the primary
Primary ledger is good enough, sir.
Primary ledger is good enough. Fine, that is okay. But what happened, the conversion is not happening. That is why in the monitor process also, we had an error, actually. Create accounting has ended in a warning, actually. Maybe in the, if you look at the execution report also, it will be showing you something.
It would be showing, yeah, sir, correct.
Now, what happens, I am going to transact on a different price, actually. I'm going to transact on a different price. So let us now go there. I will know what happens. I perform a transaction on a different price. So I will not duplicate it. So it will get averaged out. And one more thing is what? I will now go on and show it. Fine, click on it. Review item cost. So we'll now go there. Click on it now. We will now have a look at the cost now. Fine, click on it. We'll now have a look at the cost. And click on this. I will now give a review item cost. Fine, click on the review item cost. Go there. So cost starts with what happens at T01. And then your item starts with T01. We will not try to find out the price, the cost of the item. Click on it. So go there. So you go there. Now the item price is $11. But you feel that this is not the correct price. And then you want to modify the price, actually. Let us say I want to modify it to $15, actually. So we can very well adjust the cost, actually. Fine, the total unit cost is $11. I'm going to adjust the cost. Fine, click on that. Fine. Let me adjust the cost. So click on it. I will not go there. I will not go to what? Manage cost adjustment. So I go to the manage review item cost has given you $11. I will now go to the manage cost adjustment. Thank you on it. I will now say create now. Thank you on it. So there are three things for which what happens there. We can very well adjust the cost. One is what? Perpetual average. One for the layered inventory cost. That's FIFO and LIFO. And then one for the receipt cost also. So I'm now using the perpetual average. Fine. There's one. Fine. Click on search now. Fine. Go to the second point. So click on search. So here, what happens? The cost organization starts with, I will now say T01. Fine. Cost book starts with the T01. I go there. And then item starts with, I will not say T01. So let me make a search now. Fine. They, all the three are mandatory fields now. Fine, click on search. So once when you give a search, what happens? It will now show you the item. It's not working. Fine. You got it. So we are now we are going to adjust the cost. So go to the adjustment. Fine, click on the adjustment. So in the adjustment, what happens? We have to be in the edit mode now. Fine. Why is it not coming in the edit mode actually? So click on back. It will not come fine. So select it. And then what happens? We have to edit it actually. Select the cost. Why I'm not into edit mode actually? It has come. In this place, it has come very clearly. So in the adjust, we have to go into edit mode actually. There is no action button enabled actually. Fine. Click on the adjust now. Fine. Click on adjust. So anybody? Now it has come to edit mode. Yes, now it has come to edit mode. So in the adjust mode, what happens? Now, what for? We are going to have a reason also. We can very well create. Okay, go there. So we'll not create a reason for the adjustment actually. So I don't go there. Click on it. We'll not create a reason. So click on it. We'll not create a reason for the adjustment actually. Click on the setup maintenance. We'll not go to the setup maintenance. Go there. Click on it. We'll not go to what? Search. And then what happens? I will not go to the manage. Fine. Profiles basically. Fine. Manage standard lookups. Standard lookups. So I will now go to the manage standard lookups. So manage standard lookups. Manage standard lookups. I will now go to the manage standard lookups task. Where, what happens? I will now go to the CST. Fine. CST percentage. Fine. Reason percentage. I will now query for the lookup type. Lookup type was CST. So go there, click on it. So here, what happens? I will now put a reason. Fine. Click on plus. I will now say what happens. It is a what's called average cost adjustment, fine. ABG, fine. Cost adjustment, and I'm putting some code now, fine. So ABG cost adjustment. So give a reasonable name for why you're adjusting it actually. So display sequence is 2 now, fine. This is what is meaning now, and then give the description also. So we have now created a reason for this adjustment actually. Fine, give a reasonable name, fine. Give a 7 close. So that will be appearing on the one now. Fine, click on 7 close. If you go to the previous one, fine, drop it down, it will now appear on the space. Fine, click on search now. Fine, click on search. It has not just been created. Fine, click on search now. It will not show you. This is the average cost adjustment. So give a reasonable. Fine, click on it. So I'm now doing because of this reason. Fine, go there. I will now give what a new cost now directly. So one is one only. So 10, I'm going to make it as what? 15 now. I'm now making it as a 15. I'm not making it as a 15. So it's what? So 10 is one. Fine, not. So the new cost is not $11. It's $16 actually. Fine, click on next now. Fine. We can even, what happens, give a change on the amount or percentage change also, you can do it by which, what happens, you can give a new cost. So there's a different ways of giving a new cost now. So click on next, by which, what happens, it will now go to the review and then submit. So the one, so 11 will be changed to 16, and then click on submit, by which, what happens, it is now submitted. This will now go into the interface tables of costing now. Submit cost adjustment. Now it has gone to the interface tables of costing. This adjustment has gone to the interface tables of costing. You will now bring it to the base tables. You go there, you will now create a cost accounting distribution for this. So this adjustment I'm going to bring in now. Fine, go there. So I will now bring the adjustment into the base tables. Fine, click on search now. Go there. So go there. Everything is there. Fine, click on scheduling new costs again. So this will now appear as a second line. This will now appear as a second line. So go the monitor process. Fine. Go there. So this adjustment will be appearing as a second line on the distribution actually. So create cost accounting distribution. So once it is completed, what happens? It will be appearing as a second line on this. Go there. So click on save and close, and then have a look at the review distribution. Fine, click on it. I will now go to what? Review cost accounting distribution. I go there, and then I will now have a look at it. Fine. Make a start. Now first starts with the T01, and then here all of it starts with, starts with, and again T01. So T01. Make a search. There will be two entries now. Fine. One for the first entry, and then next is what? For the second entry actually. T01 cost is a cost org actually. The cost org. So T01 cost org. Click on search. There will be two entries. Fine, there are two entries. So one is a user cost adjustment, which has now come. It is not yet accounted. So once when you account it, fine, it's now fully costed. Fine, go there. It's now fully costed. So let us now go there and then see the cost of it. Fine, go to the duplicate of it. It is not costed. We'll now see the new cost. Whether the new cost has now become 16 or not, we'll now see. Fine, click on it. We'll now go to what cost overview. We'll now see the item cost, whether it is now $16 or not. Fine, you will now go to the review item cost. It is not an accounted, it is okay. Fine, cost talk starts with, as I'll now say T01. Item starts with T01. The cost must be $16. Previously it was $11. It has to go as a $16. So it has now gone to $16. One thing is what? It is not accounted. So if you run the create accounting, it will also be getting accounted. Fine. That will also be getting accounted. It's not accounted. And then that will also again land up an error, because what happens is somebody is setting up the currency conversion from USDT euro actually. So accounting may be in error. But your responsibility lies still fully costed actually. If there is a problem on the costing, then they will now ask only the supply chain consultants to, what happens, look at it actually. Because you are setting it up. Financial guys will not have time at all This portion, they will not take care of it. But this portion, you only have to take it. Now, the last part of the exercise is what? I will not transact on a different cost. So let us not go there. I will not transact on a different cost. Fine, click on it. I will not go there. So you go to the what? Inventory overview, and then let us not transact on a different cost. This is the average costing. Now, fine, click on it. I will not go to the create miscellaneous transaction. I will not transact on a different cost. Now, it will go there. My miscellaneous reserve. Now, I will not go there. I will not take up the account from this place. Now, fine, click on it. I will take up the account. So this is the opposite account. I'm taking it down. So take up the opposite account. Put the account over here. Now, fine, click on it. I will not say no. No means what? I'm going to transact on a different cost actually. So click on plus and then go there. The T01 and then give it the item. I will not put on the sub inventory if I click on it. I will not go to the edit details and then I'm going to transact on a different cost. So go there, go for 100 quantities. Sorry, I will not go for 100 quantities. Go there. So click on enter. So I will not make it double now, right? Just for understanding. Go there. Item price is going to be 20 now. Because they spend, fine, click on plus one. And then whatever the non-recoverable tax is what. Now it will now average it out. Previously the cost is $16. Now we are now making it as $20. So $16 for 100 quantities and then $20 for 100 quantities. It will now whatever they calculate the total value by total quantity. It will now calculate the total value by total quantity and then it will now average it out. Click on it. So click on submit. So the total inventory valuation by total inventory quantity will be the average cost of it. Will not go there. So go to the monitor process and I will not run it now. So no transfer transaction inventory costing fine go there. So it is already completed. Fine go there. So no, then a different costing now. Fine. Cost org is what T01 and then give a tab. And then click on submit now. Fine. It is now getting pushed into the interface tables of costing. Fine, go there. So click on it. Let us now wait for it to complete now. Fine. And now it was pull into the base tables. So once when it is completed, we'll now pull into the base tables. Running. Nobody got completed. Okay, so we'll not go there. We'll not pull it to the base table. Fine, go there. Click on it. We'll not pull it to the base tables. Fine. Go to the what? Create cost accounting distribution for the new one now. Fine, click on it. I will not say it is a T01 of the one. Fine, go there. So click on search. It will be coming. And then whatever we'll not go on and schedule the process. So this transaction will be brought into the base tables now. This transaction will be brought to the table. Fine, go there. And then the monitor process will go there. Click on it. Now the new item cost will be what? Average it out. Previously we have what happens? $16 worth of 100 quantities. Now $22 worth of 100 quantities again flowing in. So it will now see the total valuation. Fine. 16 into 100 plus 22 into 100 divided by 200. That will be the new average cost. Clear on this one? Can somebody say yes to me? Yeah. It's a very, very tough one. So this is on the average cost.
Conceptually, yes, but it's tough.
It's a lot of people. So last
of we need to go through the record again, sir.
Yeah, that's correct. You have to go through the record. So it's not running. Fine, go there. We'll now go to the cost accounting distribution. If I click on save and close and then have a look at the distribution. We'll now review the distribution. Now go to the review cost accounting distributions. Go there. So click on search again. So the third transaction has come now. So one is what? It's now partially costed because this thing is running actually. The concurrent is running. So it is not fully costed actually. So we have to wait for the concurrent to complete. It has to come as fully costed. It's not running. So go there. Click on search now. Again, search for it. So once when the concurrent gets completed, it will be fully costed. You know, it's not fully costed. It's not fully costed. So go there. We'll now go on and look at the item cost now. Fine, click on it. Go to the review item cost now. Click on review item cost. Fine. I will now say cost on starts with fine T01. And then item starts with T01. All these concurrents will all be running in the periodic fashion. So it is now $19. How it has come, we'll now see now. Fine, go to the calculator. Calculator. Fine, go there. So one is what? $16 into 100. So how much it is? 1,600. Fine. Plus 2200. Fine. Enter it. And then dividend by 200. That is 19 actually. Fine. So 16 into 100 is 1600 and then 22 into 100 is 2200. So these two things put together divided by 200 is $19 is the average cost of. Got it? It's a very tough one. So again, what happens is we landed up on a problem on the currency conversion. Somebody is setting up the currency conversion, but the primary ledger costing is very correct. Only thing is what the secondary ledger somewhere is not giving you the match. And every concurrent will all be running automatically. Nobody will run it manually at all. It's not possible at all. And tomorrow we are going to see the interog accounting, interog transfers accounting tomorrow. And these are the only two things I know. Fine. The remaining, I don't know. Fine. The remaining all will be taught by Tejil in a very systematic and methodical manner. Do attend his training. So it is a must actually for everybody to know the costing actually nowadays. Vanathi, are you clear? She is from US actually.
Yes, sir. I have to, view the record again.
How many of you are comfortable? Can you put a green tick mark on the pain now? Fine. Reactions pain. How many of you are comfortable? We'll not see it. If somebody is comfortable. Fantastic. Fine. Chinnathambi Rajan is very clear. Sibi Sendil is very clear actually. Fine. Great, great, great. So please take a note of these people. And then whenever you're getting stuck, because this will be a very big problem in the field actually. If you're not setting anything, and then if you're not getting the fully costed, fine. They will not be behind you virtually. It has to be fully costed actually. And then if you're setting up the cost values also wrongly, then also you'll be finding it a very difficult thing. So Chinnathambi Rajan and then Sibi Sendil have now put a green tick. Fine. Great, actually. Fine. It's really excellent, actually.
Nana, we have been working with this. I have been working with this costing.
Oh, Chinnathambi is already working on this. No, fine. See.
Yeah, I've been already working in this, in the office. Hence, I have been familiar with this.
Then I have explained everything correctly.
Yes, Nana. Yes, everything. Apart from that, the thing, the challenging is comes on the manufacturing work order costing data. That is very, very challenging.
Oh, God. I don't know manufacturing and then I don't know costing also. What happens? That is again a big problem. Many are asking me to read, but what happens? I'm not getting the mood to read, actually sit and read. Whenever I get the mood, I will now contact a training on manufacturing. Others, what about your comment? Lingeshwari, you must have put a green tick mark. She is now understanding things very fast.
Sir, I attended second time, first, but
but even then it is difficult.
I have to study.
You have to study that. Very good, very good, very good. Gautam, is it clear for you?
I'll have to review
the recording now. Okay, 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 fine. So bye for now, and then we'll now meet at 6 p.m. tomorrow, and then we'll now begin the tough topic of interog accounting, interog transfers accounting. Bye now.
Thank you, Nana.
Bye.
Thank you, Nana.
Bye.
Bye. Thank you, sir.
Bye. Thank you, sir.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Good day.
Good night. Good night. Good night. Bye. Vikram, is it clear now? Vikram, are you there? Vikram might have left, I think. Good then, fine, yeah, fine. Bye for now.